Over the last few years, on average, we've built about 170,000 houses every year. Last year, it was a bit higher. But you can see there is a problem. And to solve this, Boris Johnson is trying, his government are trying, to ease the planning rules, which can be lengthy and can be cumbersome. It's led to Theresa May saying it means we'll build the wrong houses in the wrong places. And what she's saying is it means it's the home counties where we'll see houses being built, when actually there are other parts of the country further north that perhaps need them even more. Now, this has led to, not just from Theresa May, it's led to quite a major potential backbench rebellion, and one of those very much in this fight is Bob Seeley, the Conservative MP for the Isle of Wight. Bob, good evening.
Good evening, Nigel, and good evening to your growing number of viewers on GB News.
Thank you very much. Great to see you, and a lovely view. It's not raining, and of course...
No, not quite.
And you have one of the most beautiful parts of southern England that you represent. You've also, of course, got the biggest electorate of any seat in the Houses of Parliament. So you're fighting Boris on these planning rules. What specifically do you want to see changed?
Well, I just want to understand what the principles are behind what is being planned. If it's just shoving more houses in places, I think you're going to have a problem, because we've had 50 years. OK, I'll take the Isle of Wight. For 50 years, we haven't been NIMBYs, we've been YIMBYs, we've been in our backyard. We've increased our population by 50,000, 50% over 50 years. At the same time, Hull, Bradford, Liverpool, Manchester, Birmingham, Blackpool have all got, not relatively smaller, but in absolute senses smaller. So if you keep ramming housing into the southeast of England, but also in Tory suburbs and rural areas up and down the country, you are overpopulating some areas and underpopulating others. And people, our voters, as you know, Nigel, well enough, are getting fed up, because they're saying, what's happening to our greenfields? What's, you know, our surgeries are under pressure. We don't have the infrastructure on the Isle of Wight. So for sure, we need houses. I just want to correct your stats, if I may. We built 252,000 last year.
I did say last year was higher. I said the average for the last 10 years was about 170,000.
You're absolutely right on that. But if Boris, the 300,000 figure is purely arbitrary, and it's based on the 2014 figures, which are now arguably out of date. If Boris had chosen a different year, we'd be hitting our targets already.
Yeah, but Bob, you know, what you're really saying then is you want local councils to decide this rather than central government targets. Is that really the nub of what this rebellion is about?
Yes, but we all need to build houses in moderate numbers. But if you take the Isle of Wight, our natural population is going to, that's everyone on the island at the moment, without folks moving from the mainland, it's going to decline by about 9,000 over the next 15 years. So actually, we don't need any houses, because if the island was just looking after island population, we're going to be about 10,000 souls smaller in 15 years' time, as some of our older folks sadly die off. But so our housing market on the island is entirely skewed by retirees paying cash. But because of some of the ridiculous algorithms and methodologies used, we are then told we need to build 600 houses a year for a declining population. Now, if we had limited space, that's fine, but 70% of our development is on greenfield land. That affects our tourism economy. People come to the Isle of Wight for the beauty that you see behind me, not for the beauty of our bungalow housing estates. And that's a massive chunk of our economy. So if the government is saying, actually, we're going to squeeze your tourism economy over the next 20, 30 years until you become suburbanised, that has significant impact. It has significant impact on infrastructure, on services, on quality of life, on a landscape celebrated by Tennyson and Turner and all these other folks. And these are big questions.
Welcome to the GB News YouTube channel. You can watch us live 24 hours a day, catch up on your favourite shows and join in the conversation in the comments below.
Don't forget to subscribe and you'll never miss any of our exclusive content.